there's only been one women's doubles second round match played so far. That's in the bottom half of the draw, as you can see from that. I can tell you that the defending champions, Lee So-hee and Shin Sung-chan, are the number one seeds. There they are at the top of the draw. And the beaten finalists from 2018, the Stoyeva sisters, Gabriella and Stephanie, are they also in this half of the draw. In fact, I can tell you with the women's doubles, the two finalists from the last French Open are the number one and two seeds, because in the bottom half of the draw, Kim So-young and Kong Hee-young are the number two seeds, and they lost in the final to their teammates at the last edition of the French Open. So here come the Thai pair, Chong Kong Pan Kititharakul and Rawinda Prajongjai, up against Rachel Honderich and Kristin Tsai. And this, I can also tell you, will be a first meeting between these two pairs. The pair from Thailand, number one on the Road to Bali rankings at the moment. So that confirms what I've just been telling you. Our court officials from France and Austria. So the Canadians have chosen to serve, having won the toss. And an indication, perhaps, that there is very little drift, the fact that the number three seeds have just chosen to stay this near side of the court. So, Chong Kong Pan Kititharakul is 28 years of age, born in Chiang Mai, the ancient city in northern Thailand. Beautiful place it is too. And she and her partner are currently number 8 on the world rankings, but they did spend 1 week back at the beginning of July 2018 at number 6 on the world ranking. Rawinda Prajongjai is also 28 years of age, born in the Thai capital of Bangkok. Gold medalists at the Southeast Asian Games back in 2017. And they've already won a title this year. That was the Orleans Masters Super 100 event, and also reached the final of the YONEX Thailand Open. That was a 1,000 event. They beat Finn Ibsen and Sorov from Denmark in the first round, 16 and 12. As we look at the Canadians, Rachel Honderich, born in Toronto, in Ontario, the most populous city in Canada, Toronto. Tall lady, as you can see. Well, actually, I've got her down at 178. That's 5'10", which makes her extremely tall. And looking at her on court, I think probably she is 5'10". Kristin Tsai is 26 years of age, born in Tainan, one of the oldest cities in Chinese Taipei. Moved to Canada age 1. Started playing badminton because of her two older brothers that played. Now, in the first round, they beat the pair from Estonia, Maran and Rutel, 21-17, 21-12. In 36 minutes. So the Canadian pair lost by their first round match, or won their first round match by one, losing just one more point than their opponents won their first round match. So very, very similar scores and time on court. The first rounds. Now there is Sara Lee from Tongkang. won the mixed doubles title here, did Sara Lee back in 2010 with Subkip Prakamol. Beaten Mikkel Fuchs and Birgit Overzeer.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, young golf fan Kititharakul and Ravinda Prajongjai, Thailand. And on my left, Rachel Honderich and Kristen Tsai, Canada. Rachel Honderich to serve to young golf fan Kititharakul, love all, play.
So the Canadian pair of Honderich and Tsai getting this second round women's doubles match underway. Their opponents, the number three seeds, Kititharakul and Prajongjai. That's a beautiful, beautiful drop by Kititharakul. This Thai pair had a good week last week at the Denmark Open, reached the semi-final before losing to the eventual champions, Kwon Dong Ping and Cheng Yu. What a great interception by Kristen Tsai. That's just long.
So it's over. 2-0.
Well, the Canadian pair making their third appearance, third consecutive appearance here at the French Open. Never previously had they won a match. So they've already bettered their PB, their personal best. One Canadian pair who have won this title previously. Rally, yeah, well finished off. But the only pair from Canada to have won the women's doubles title here, you have to go back to 1982, which was long before the inception of the Super Series and now World Tour. And that pair was Joanne Faladou and Linda Cloutier, the only ever winners of the women's doubles title at the French Open. And I have to say, that year, Canada won four titles at the French Open. They won the women's singles, women's doubles and mixed doubles. Only the men's singles eluded Canadian players in 1982. Well left.
Service over. 6-5-4.
Yeah, umpire court quickly correcting herself. Service error from the side.
7-5.
Three consecutive gold medals, the Canadian pair at the Pan Am Championships. Also gold medals at the Pan Am Games. North Pan Am Games, which were in Lima in 2019. Lima, Peru. Ah, it's good work from Kititharakul at the front of the court. Variation of serve out wide.
So it's over.
Yeah, right on top of the net, really threatening. That's a nice idea from Honderich.
10-6.
Good interception again from Kititharakul. And the number three seeds from Thailand go to the mid-game interval with a 5-point advantage. Play in the French League and train here in France between tournaments, the Canadians. There's a challenge here. I thought she might have touched it, actually. it's clearly in.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Service over. 7-11. Play.
Good rally. Oh my goodness. Yeah, gone wide.
8-11.
That was a wonderful retrieving and block back to the net from Prajongjai. Rachel Honderich comes from a sporting family. Her mother was one of the top junior golfers in Canada, won the under-19 National Golf Championships. Rachel has chosen the sport of badminton. Wow, this is a good fight.
10-11.
By the Canadians. Completely mistimed it. She was there. She could have played it.
12-10.
That's a lovely little push. Richard dropped her racket. Hesitation from the line judge, and I think Prajongjai was wondering whether to challenge, but they've only got one challenge left. Now it did look out, difficult to tell from that. Have been going long.
Oh.
Oh, what a beautiful, beautiful touch there from Kititharakul. Watch this backhand. She looks as if she's going to play a kill, and then the delicate little block. Oh, nice work from Rawinda Prajongjai.
18-11.
Well, the run comes to an end, but five straight points. Oh, good return of serve. Nice block. I think she was right to go for it.
20, game point 30.
For game point opportunities now. For the number three seeds, Kititharakul and Prajongjai. And that's landed in. That's a misjudgment from Kristin Tsai. And it means that the opening game goes to the number three seeds, Kititharakul and Prajongjai from Thailand. 21-13 the scoreline in 17 minutes.
Second game, love ball, play.
Oh.
is over.
So very, very important, I think, that the Canadians don't just allow their opponents to control the front court area. Well, that's certainly helping their cause with a lucky net court. That's well worked. It's a very committed backhand defense that Rachel Honderich has. Committed to the backhand grip. Very distinctive backhand grip. Yeah, far more attacking play at the start of this second game from the Canadians. And it's serving them well. Defense. Oh, goodness. Good rally. Long rally, too. Possibly the longest of the match so far. It's definitely the longest of the match so far. Surprised that one of the players has asked for a towel down. And that's Kititharakul. Psychologically, that was an important rally. 92 shots, my goodness me. Yeah. Longest rally by far. That's good attacking play. Oh my goodness, she's fallen over. Tsai, she's okay. Oh, then they got in each other's way. Well, another long, long rally.
Yeah.
Yeah, she literally just trips over there, comes back up, but they both go to defend the straight one. There she's gone. Tsai gets back up. Yeah, that's very well spotted, I have to say, by the Thailand pair to see where the gap was. So back level, 4-4. Yeah. No, it's the Thailand pair back on the attack.
5-4.
Yeah. Well, it's obviously a battle as to which pair can get on the attack within the rallies, because whichever pair can do that is winning the point. Five straight points for the number three seeds from Thailand. Today is Kititharakul. Seven straight points. And it was that long, long rally. 92 shots when the Canadians were winning 4-1. And since then, every rally so far since that point has been won by the Thai pair. 1 point ends at 8. The differences between these two pairs so far has been the fact that Kititharakul and Prajongjai can turn their defensive play into attacking play with drive defense, with nice blocks. Canadians seem to have more problems with that. Yeah. There was the attempt, the block from Kristin Tsai. But it was simply too loose, and therefore the Thai pair could continue their attack like that. Service fault court. Kititharakul.
7-10.
It's a four-point advantage for the number three seeds at the mid-game interval here in the second game, having already won the first. Well, they had a good spell, the Canadians, after the mid-game interval of the opening game. I wonder if history is going to repeat itself. That's a good drive defense. I like that from Honderich. Oh, that's a beauty. Big gap. Yeah, guiding the shuttle across courts. This one. That's such a super shot from Prajongjai. Afford errors like that. Oh, clash of rackets. Yeah, smashed racket. Kititharakul's racket. Absolutely smashed. There we go. Lovely defence. Now that's the sort of drive defence that their opponents have been using against them. That was a super shot from Rachel Honderich. good defense. Yeah, frustrated with herself, Tsai. That again, the umpire was having a word with the Thailand coach, telling her not to coach during rallies. I don't think anybody would have heard anything. So much involvement from the fans. I don't think the players would have heard anything anyway. Position, Canadians. Now they've got themselves back. Oh, but that lift is long.
So it's over.
Good channel attack there from Tsai. Steadily working their way through this match, the number three seeds. Five-point advantage restored. Can't penetrate the attack, the Canadians, of their opponents.
Service over. 13-18.
Of course, I meant to say penetrate the defence of their opponents.
Okay.
Good serve. Nice drop. Oh, big dive. Amazing. Good rally. Fabulous rally. Just wide. The longest, four shots shy of the longest so far. Oh, what an amazing rally. This is another good rally. Well, just 2 points in it now. 16-18. Yeah, that's a good interception. Oh, my goodness. Well,
service over.
Scrambling by Prajongjai.
19-16.
And this one turned into pretty much a perfect shot because she gets the net cord from that. That's amazing. Another dive from Mr. Tsai.
Service
Yeah, now what came off her there? Something, but came off her, bounced on the floor. No, I'm not terribly sure. But it's match point opportunities now. Three of them for the number three seeds, Kititharakul and Prajongjai. And they convert on their first. Kititharakul and Prajongjai beat Honderich and Tsai 21-13, 21-17. In a match lasting 47 minutes.
Match won by Yongolfan, Kititharakul and Ravinda Prajongjai, 21-13, 21-17.
Seventh time this year in eight tournaments that this pair from Thailand has reached at least the quarter-final stage. The only time they didn't manage to do that was the All England Championships. So that's great consistency from Kititharakul and Prajongjai. This is the final rally. And safely through to yet another quarter final. First at the French Open, though, for Kititharakul and Prajongjai. The margin of their victory, 47 minutes in total. So just one more match to come here on second round action from the French Open here in Paris, and our last match is women's singles, and it's the reigning world champion Pusala Venkatasindhu of India up against Lina Christoffersen of Denmark. Christoffersen is the European Championship silver medalist. Well, when we look